Okay, you sure you want to start there?
Yes. I'll wait.
Ah, and just give it like a slow rotating camera. Or just like that.
Yeah, it's good. Hey, get out of the shot! You're ruining everything! You bastard! He's just standing!
Dad, thank you.
Begin recording in 3, 2... Magica, 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 satan! Hello everyone, Ado here.
And Tiffany, and Tsuyoi. Get out of the shot!
And we're back. A harem tale. Because it doesn't just look like the classic girls that you would see in a harem. Mm-hmm. Yeah, you got the sporty one with the ponytail, mm-hmm. The quiet, gentle one with the blue hair, then the, let's see, what's the word, not family friend, oh yeah, the childhood friend that you grew up with, and the I'm totally legal one.
Yes, and the gay option who won't get out of the picture! From now on, you're gay! It's your thing!
Right.
Hey, Helix, how's it? Wow, you are darting around. What are you so excited about, Helix?
Hey! Oh, god dang it. Yeah, I'm wearing my glasses.
Oh. Okay. Okay, don't worry!
What's a wedding? Bianca and Nara keep talking about it. Slurp. Is it a kind of party? Can I goo?
a philosophical question for the ages. Can I goo?
Not on the floor, Helix. We told you this 1,000 times.
Yeah, we actually already did like a quick inspection of everybody. And like everyone has everything the same except for Helix and these girls.
And the bar.
And of course the bar. Like,
which one were you? You were her, right? Yeah, you were her.
No, wait. I had an awesome accent. I wasn't her. And she ain't speaking with an accent right now.
Yes, you're right. So this is me.
Right.
I understand all too well the pain of being separated from one's father and one's beloved. We cannot ignore Beryl's plight. We mustn't.
Hey, double tap.
Oh. Same.
Good enough. I'm gonna try something a bit different. What, you want me to continue on as before? Just being all plain speak about it?
Go ahead. Well, anything different from you will be interesting.
Okay, I'm lost. Going back to safe space. Don't you go fretting about us. The important thing is that we find them missing dwarves and fast.
Whoa. Where'd they go?
Your Majesty, everyone, thank you so much to coming. Thank you so much to coming for Granite's rescue.
Thank you so much for coming to Granite's rescue.
Nonsense! We can only leave your home to be ravaged by the rampaging hordes. Besides, our work has barely begun. We have yet to free the town, much less find your father. But tell me, my dear, what has become of the once bustling city of Granite? We haven't seen any trace of your dwarven compatriots, not to mention the Foreman himself.
Well, it all started a few days ago. Hundreds and hundreds of monsters started swimming in through the tunnels and attacking us. Father and my beloved got everyone together and started leading them off to safety. But the monsters were so fierce, it was all confusing. We lost sight of them.
Okay.
So that's why you were by yourself. You went to try and find them, didn't you?
Yes.
Yes, but I shouldn't have done that. But I shouldn't have done, should I? All I managed to do was get myself surrounded by monsters and end up causing trouble for everyone.
What?
It was no trouble. We were just walking through it anyway.
Yes.
Indeed we were.
But here we will remain until the monsters are driven out and your father is found. Fear not, fair maiden. All will be well.
Wow.
Oh, thank you. Thank you so much. Yeah. Mm-hmm. We needed you to save our asses.
Double tap.
Yes.
They have to be safe. I just know it. I won't give up until they're found.
Oh, don't forget Bianca.
Bye.
Crikey.
That's the same.
Okay.
Bar time!
Right. But anyways, yeah. Went around, talked to everybody. All had the same thing to say. including the little girl who was all like, can you bring me a dwarf? We got one like right down the hall from her and she's still asking to see a dwarf.
Yes.
I wonder if Bianca and Nera's appearance in our world is connected to the other odd occurrences of late.
Maybe.
Hey!
So Bianca and Nera are travelers from another world too, are they? Their loved ones must be worried sick about them.
Must be.
I have attempted use of weapons such as axe and whip previously, but Kuro would not cease castigating. I'm gonna say castrating.
Yeah, I know, right?
But Kuro would not cease castigating me for use of uncouth arms. A pity, they are such premium fun.
Since when is a whip uncouth? It's a torture device. It's not uncouth. Three brides to be at once, eh? What are the chances of that? Anyway, we need to sort things out in Granite so Barrow can have her special day.
Hey, you!
The foreman's still missing! We need to find him before the monsters do!
Hey. Oh, wait. I already talked to you. Sorry, my bad.
It's great surprise indeed to simultaneously encounter three brides-to-be. Sir Hev Nama, too, must one day become bride-to-be also. Bianca and Nera, now there's a pair of proper ladies. Know what I mean? Not like old bossy boots. Bossy boots. Is she even wearing boots? Yeah, I guess she is. Small boots, but they're boots.
Did you already talk to the king?
No, I didn't. I was kind of swiveling to look for him, but how did I miss him?
Where can the foreman have disappeared to? I'm beginning to fear the worst. Come, we must resume our search with all haste.
All haste. Post haste. End of haste.
I'll do haste.
Also, I went back and fought those bosses in a timed attack mode. Beat them, too. Except for this one on gold. Oh, no, wait. This one I did do. Didn't I?
No. No, you got silver.
Yeah, okay. Every other one I got gold, but not that one.
Right. Why don't you show them what you got? You remember how to do that, yeah?
Yeah. Got big maps.
Yeah.
Color maps.
Super massive map. And full-colored laser-printed map.
Right. Oh, wait, there's a zoom out. That's so good. I don't have to, like, scroll around anymore.
Looking for love in all the right places. This party discovers a dwarf's foreman's daughter. The dwarven foreman's daughter fighting alongside two young women who claim to have come from another world. Help these unlikely allies find the foreman and his daughter's betrothed. Back in we go.
Yeah, I remember not liking this stage too much.
Oh, boy. Oh, boy!
Maybe because it's sort of like an escort mission.
Oh, well, I mean, because she's going to be moving.
Yep.
Here we are, friends. Leave no stone unturned in our ongoing search for the missing dwarves. Ah, but alas, we are not acquainted with the lay of the land. Fair maiden, would you do the honor of acting as guide?
It'd be my pleasure. Now then, let's see. Yes, we should try the cave to the north first.
It's you.
Oh, okay. Yes, of course. The darker depths beyond would make for a fine hiding place. Alright, let's get to work. Stick close, love. Nera and I will look after you. Don't you worry. Now let's find your dad.
Oh wait, we gotta stick with him.
Yeah, like, I find... I find missions like these annoying because it's essentially go to this place and like explore it or clear out the enemies. Like, okay, we checked this out area, let's move on to the next one. But here they added the element of where you have to wait for the person who's trying to show you where to go to catch up to where you've already been. And not only that, you have to protect them along the way. So you pretty much have to slow your pace to their pace and guard them from like anything and everything along the way.
I suppose that's true, as long as she stays out of danger, it's not that bad though, right? Like, she's gonna stay away from this guy, right?
She's gonna hold position in a certain area, but certainly not one of those don't run off the safety. Like, I bet she's just standing like in the middle of the hall somewhere right now.
Alright then.
Alright then.
He's not here. Come on, let's look somewhere else.
Like, see, you can't even go off and explore all that much because you have to keep up with her.
Well, at least someone stayed with her.
Oh, well, that's one good thing about that is that Bianca and Nera will usually always be by her side. Like, they'll be within her vicinity. But, of course, you know, they're computer-controlled player characters.
So they're only so good.
Yeah, they don't have the upgrades that they could possibly have if you were controlling them. So, they're only going to be so effective. It's pretty much just going to be you keeping the enemies away.
That's fair. So, any points of something to discuss? I remember you saying last time you did.
Oh. Ah, you're done with your stuff. I can finally speak about the stuff that I want to speak about.
Yeah, absolutely.
I can do it.
Can you? Do you have the power? Is the power yours?
I have the power. Anyway. So, I watched this one guy. Why am I forgetting his name? This YouTuber, who I find rather interesting. He did a review off a game that I've always seen, but I never really, like, gave a try or anything like that before in the past.
Huh.
I just really wish I could remember that YouTuber.
Well,
Weegee? Yeah, I think it was, Weegee Plays. Yeah, Weegee Plays. He did a review off of Naruto Online.
Ah.
Have you seen that video of his?
I've seen the thumbnail.
Alright. So, like, I was like, oh,
I wonder if our dads are out looking for us, too. Oh, my. I hadn't thought of that. Papa's probably dragged the entire village out of bed to look for me. Poor things. Bloomin' heck. We'd better get home before he has an heart attack.
Maybe it's behind the gigantic door.
You know, it's probably great that I have her. I mean, she's just dropping those H's all over the place. I mean, you know, I like Elos as much as the next person, but still.
You two came from the same town, right? Have you known each other for a long time? Not really. We're friends, but we haven't known each other for long at all. Only a few days, in fact. But Bond, you enjoy you so much firm. I am certain you have a chance of protracted standing.
Just a slash.
I can understand why. I felt close to being here the very first moment we met.
Oh my.
But not as close as Sun. There's a certain person she's very close to indeed. Isn't there? You are? Well, I suppose. Yeah.
That's it.
Dad, are you there?
God, this map.
Yeah. Pretty neat dwarven stage, I suppose. I mean, big old furnace down in the center like that.
You bastard! I was gonna use that on you, and you had to just rush in.
Yeah. You know, I might as well just use those golems. Free up space in your monster medals to get more monsters and what have you. Because, you know, the monster medals, like, they're not my wish to take a monster and raise it, but they are nice with how you're able to just get a majority of good stuff and just spam that. It's a nice alternative. But, yeah, I just kind of find the timing of that level up that happened just there. Like, you got Bianca to admit her feelings! Yeah.
Is that what that was?
No, I think Yankus just leveled up.
Ah.
But still, I said, oh, that's nice timing. I do love it whenever social links level up in games. What's up? Ah! That golem just socked that dinosaur right in the kisser.
Boom!
Yeah. So anyways, so I'm watching Weegee play review Naruto online, and I've always had like an interest. Oh, don't worry about that. That's one of Nera's things. Now, I've always had an interest in Naruto Online. It seems like, oh, so it's just like the Xenoverse for Naruto. Choose a character, do stuff in Narutoverse. Thing is, it was like this online computer game and you had to like sign up for it. And I was like, screw that, because like I really don't like to sign up for stuff.
Yeah, same here.
Yeah, and I was like,
he's not here. Come on, let's look somewhere else.
And that's just like, you know, putting my information out there, which I generally dislike doing. So.
Same here. That's exactly the reason I don't like doing it.
Yeah, but I saw him playing it, giving it some tries, and you know, he had his whole thing, he was making fun of it and stuff like that. Like most reviewers like to do with whatever they're reviewing.
Yeah.
But he was like also showing off some stuff that like he may have been exaggerating with like how hype it was.
Uh-huh.
But he certainly did seem...
I didn't think she could jump.
Dad! Dad, are you there?
Like, yeah, probably over-exaggerating the hype. You might as well...
He's not here. Come on, let's look somewhere else.
Yeah. You might as well discard that golem that's near death. And it's like, oh, okay, like, he most probably certainly was hyping it up, but, like, the fun he was expressing having and doing certain things, it was just, like, it made the game seem like, you know, if you can fake this much fun, it might probably be interesting. Of course, at some point in the video, he was all like, and I know I'm joking, but I wouldn't be talking about this unless I...
I'm a serial killer.
No, serial skiller.
Oh.
Okay. He said he wouldn't be doing it unless he, like, legit had some fun with the game. And I'm gonna take his word on it for now. Hasn't lied to me before, I think. Not too sure about that. But, oh yeah, use your imp. You remember what that does, don't you?
Oh yeah.
And, okay, you know, I'll go give it a try. So I started up the game, and I was like, sign in with your, like, email and a password. And I'm like, fine.
So you created a throwaway email account?
I used one of my alts.
Dad, are you there?
Maybe they're just hiding in heaven.
All in one place suits me just fine. I was getting tired of chasing them around everywhere.
So I started up like the account in the game, and it was like, you know, choose your ninja. And usually when it comes to games to where, like, you know, you take your character and you do things, you usually have two ways to go about it. You have a generic create a character to where you mix and match clothing and like some skills and like you give them a name.
Right.
Or you have a pretty well-defined preset of a character that clearly has their own thing going on, and because of that they're able to give them character specific stuff that makes it like, okay, here's what makes you cool as a character compared to everyone else. That's the method that Naruto Online uses. So they had like five characters to choose from, each one representing like one of the five ninja elements. There's only five, right?
I believe so.
Let's see, wind, water, fire, lightning, and
darkness?
Dark. Is that it?
Maybe. I feel like it is, but I'm not 100% sure on that.
Okay. But anyways, like, they had, like, characters that's each to represent one of them and stuff like that. I mean, you could rename them, but still, you're pretty much choosing, like, a preset character that had their own stuff going on. So I was thinking, okay, so I can't create my avatar that is Atou. Because, like, no one there had green hair.
I see.
Yeah. So I'm just gonna have to... And, like, they had little descriptions of each character and stuff, what they could do. Like, what it is that they represented as their character. this thing, you know, okay, so let's see. There's this one guy who had a lightning blade, dealt with quick attacks. Okay, that's neat.
Yeah.
There's another dude who was earth. Yeah, I think that was the other element.
Right.
Like ground and stuff, and like he's like the rough and tumble, you know, knock you down, heroes, or, you know, where it's then.
Of course.
Yep. And then you have the not Naruto of the group that was the wind user. That, like, you know, it was just basically imagine Temari but able to use Rasengan. And that's what she essentially came down to. And then we found one character who spoke to me the most.
Huh.
And that
support? Go ahead and tell yourself.
Yeah. And that was like this girl with blue hair, and she had water as her element.
Uh-huh.
And yes, she was basically support. It's like use water to attack your foes. Ooh. Or use your chakra blades to restore health to allies or something.
Yeah.
And it, why don't you use your monster? I mean, I got like a big old troll just like right there, waiting to go.
Nice.
Yeah, getting the thousands that one did. But, yeah, I was like, oh, okay, this is good, because usually in games that I play, like, I believe in the power of friendship, which means having a whole bunch of teammates to help me out. And the best way to advocate the power of friendship is to be someone that can facilitate the power of friendship. That you do recall you can revive allies, right?
Yeah. Oh, I didn't know they were dead.
Jeez.
Not paying attention to, like, your ally bars to the left?
Yeah. My bad.
Certainly not a believer in the power of friendship you are, huh?
Hey, because, don't say it like that! Oh god, I froze them, they can't go over there!
Yeah. Because someone like me, with the way I play, I'm always supporting my teammates, and I try to be a powerhouse in my own right, but the thing is, you know, I'm certainly gonna, like, try to prioritize, like, healing my allies than not.
I believe in my own power of friendship, Ado. Mine is to beat the enemies so hard they can't hurt my friends, because they're too busy dying.
That's not the power of friendship.
It's the power of me.
Like, that's the exact opposite of the power of friendship.
It's my
That's the power of
friendship.
The self, of not even trusting your allies.
That's how you look at it.
Yeah, because yours is wrong.
They can... Your interpretation of how you do, why you do what you do, and why you believe what you believe is incorrect. Really? I thought I beat on things so hard that they could never reach the friends supporting me from behind. Like, if you're supporting me from behind, I'm not letting them reach you.
Well, no, because I have played co-op games with you. You're usually dying all the time, and I'm having to revive you. And in the process of reviving you, I get hurt in the process. It's hard to support you because you're always going off like the lone wolf. I will take him on by myself.
Isn't that only in God Eater? And that's because you're supposed to heal me from afar with healing bullets, but I just die too quickly to be healed. It's because I suck at defense. I need to get better at it. I'm not perfect.
You're trying to be the shield of the group, and yet you don't even defend.
I suck at blocking.
And so, like, you bring, like, no support to the team. That is not the power of friendship.
It's supposed to be. I just suck at it. Wow, we searched every nook and cranny, but there's no sign of them. Are they dead yet? Can we just accept it? The only place left is a sanctum. If they're not there, then...
Sanctum is holy place, yes? Surely such a place can afford to them protection. Sure, they must assuredly be there.
Yes, I'm sure you're right.
I know he is. My hunches aren't often wrong, but sometimes they are.
The monsters, too, may be seeking them there. We must proceed with caution.
Now I'm hurt.
Yeah, the truth stings.
So do lies.
Lies don't hurt.
Lies can hurt.
No, they don't.
They can, if you're sensitive. Maybe I'm sensitive.
Really? Like me lying to you that you're the greatest support that there ever was rushing into the enemies?
If I knew it was a lie, it would sting.
See? Lies don't hurt. The truth hurts.
You know, it also hurts. Bees. But I don't want any bees around here. Well, that doesn't mean I don't want truth.
Okay, so anyways, let's talk to everybody.
I understand all too well. Oh, wait, this is before. This is the same thing.
Yeah. Oh, okay. Well, you know, just like once over.
They have to be safe. I know it. I just... Oh, that's the same, too. That's the same, too.
Okay.
Missing dwarves. But Helix surely is something new, right? Nope.
What's, what? Yeah.
Well, the bar surely has something new. It can't not! Right? Everyone's in different positions.
Yes.
Nope, that's the same.
Okay,
No, that's the same. Same.
I wonder if this is because, this stage is...
Just the same?
No, it's like, the way that, these stages progress is different compared to the other one. Usually it's always been rules of three.
Hey, you!
Outer area, inner area, boss chamber. But, as you've seen from here, you've had an outer area, an inner area, an inner area, and next is like,
the innermost area?
Yeah, with the boss chamber.
Well, Jesus, I guess... Wow, I mean, everything's gotta be the same, except for Doric here.
Okay, yeah, let's talk to Doric.
You continue to advance in the arts of war, my brave captains. Your unstoppable progress gives me great pleasure indeed. It's time for the next great secret of the true masters of combat to be revealed to you.
Ah, the true masters.
Great.
By a secret, do you mean? Yes, my friends, a new trial awaits you. And should you overcome it, a hitherto unimaginable power shall be yours. Should you wish to accept the challenge, visit the quest mistress, then make your way to trial isle without delay. Yes, we have the time for this. Where can the foreman have disappeared to? I'm beginning to fear the worst. Come, we must resume our search with all haste. Unless you want to go do the other thing.
Well, I do, but this isn't the right person. Hello.
The kingdom needs your help.
Take on a quest. Intensely train. Gragwort says, hungry for more yet?
Good, because another trial for you. This time we'll be dragging out some of the power hiding in your lumbering hide. Come to trial aisle when you're ready, and not before.
I accept it. I accept your humble train. I humbly accept your training.
Take care.
So, yeah, do a quick once around and talk to everybody. This will give me a chance to expound a bit more about what I've been saying.
Oh, no.
You are like a failed tank. It's like, that's the best way I can equate it. Like, you know, who goes out and takes damage for the party in order to keep them safe? The tank.
Yeah, you're right. That is true.
Right. That's usually the designation of them. Well, don't forget to talk to the postmistress behind her stuff.
Well, that's what I said, though. I didn't say I go out to try to tank. I go out to try to kill enemies so quickly that they can't hurt anybody. I want to be the guy that does so much damage that enemies die before they can ever hurt anybody. But I can't kill them quickly enough, usually in the games that we play together.
Yeah, that just reminds me of... What, is this new?
No.
Okay. Don't forget to grab your chest. Yeah, that just reminds me of this other character archetype that I hear about more often than not. The ninja.
Ninja?
The person that goes off by themselves to basically sneak attack the enemy and one-shot them down before anyone else has a chance to do that. that's more in line with what you're trying to do. But at least the ninja knows when to run away. You know, which you don't.
Doesn't work in God either, unless you throw a flash grenade in their face.
You totally run away. Mm-hmm. Lead them to the party so we have to deal with it. But then again, that would involve using the power of teamwork of getting your allies involved.
You can't fight though, can you? You're support, right? That's you're specialized to do a little bit of everything.
Yeah, I specialize to do a little bit of like everything to where if I am not healing my allies, then I am doing big ol' attacks, like, on the enemy.
I admit, I suck at teamwork. Sometimes. I sometimes suck at teamwork.
Really? Because I remember this time when we were playing one of the Mario games with Ray.
Yes.
And you just kept on running off on your own, regardless of how many times you got everybody killed.
Admittedly so, and that is one of those times I suck at teamwork. But I think we played something co-op recently that we were okay at. Didn't we?
Oh, you mean Enter the Gungeon? That time when, like, you were gonna let me run across the bridge, but you went, tripped the platform, and when I tried to run across, I immediately fell down.
Remember that time I told you to throw that thing down the hole, and it did not help us, and it actually ruined us?
No. What, is this also an enter the dungeon?
Yes. Where, like, we were in a shop, and you threw some... No, I threw something down the hole. Yes, I remember saying I wanted that, you know, co-op experience to be a good one to, you know, prove that I can do it. We need to get another game or keep playing that one. I want to be good, damn it. I really do.
Well,
we can't do anything now.
Okay. So, next time when we come back, let's take on the trial to get you a new power. And then we'll hopefully find Beryl's missing family. Or get a new party member aboard the ship.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, one of the two. An orphan dwarf, or, you know, we help her with her big day. I'm sad now.
We'll see everyone in the next episode.